Welcome back, children. In this session, we will study about the different types of combustion. But before proceeding, we will just recapitulate the terms which we have already studied in our previous class. First of all, we studied about what is combustion, that it is simply a chemical process in which a substance burns in air or oxygen with the help of or with the release of heat and light. That is known as combustion. Then we also learnt about combustible material. What are combustible material? It is combustible material are the substance which undergoes combustion. It is also known as fuels, and about different types of fuels we have studied: solid, liquid and gaseous fuel. Then the third topic which we have studied was what are the conditions required for combustion, and in that we have studied that oxygen is necessary for combustion. Then the substance should be combustible, that is, stone can't undergo combustion because it is non-combustible material. Only that substance can undergo combustion which is combustible. And the third point was that it should attain the ignition temperature. That means the substance can catch fire only when it is able to attain the or reach the ignition temperature. And what is ignition temperature? That we have already understood, that what is ignition temperature? It is the minimum temperature at which the substance catches fire. Now we will study about the different types of combustion. Before proceeding, first of all, the objectives. At the end of this chapter or at the end of this session, we will be able to answer what are the different types of combustion. Number two, what are the different examples of different kind of combustion? And the third one is, what are the differences between the different kind of combustion? First one is types of combustion. First one is slow combustion. Slow combustion, it is also known as incomplete combustion. It is also known as incomplete combustion. Here the combustible materials burns at a slow rate, and it occurs only when there is insufficient, or you can say limited, supply of air. It never gets really completed. Now what will be the examples of slow combustion? Examples of slow combustion, the first one will be burning of cow dung cakes. Burning of wood. These are the examples of slow combustion. Now, the second one is rapid combustion. Children, before going to this topic, we will just take an example that you might have seen your mother as she put on the knob of a gas stove and ignite the burner, then there is production of large amount of heat and light. It is an example of rapid combustion. Or you can take an example when you suppose to struck a matchstick against the side of a matchbox, then what happens? The matchstick burns rapidly. This is also an example of rapid combustion. So, examples of rapid combustion will be what? Combustion of LPG, petrol, all these are the examples of rapid combustion. Now we will just do a comparison study between a slow combustion and rapid combustion. Here children, you see that slow combustion is an incomplete combustion, whereas rapid combustion, you see, it is a complete combustion. Then slow combustion, it takes place at a very slow rate, whereas the rapid combustion takes place at fast rate. Here there is insufficient supply of air. That is, insufficient supply of air means what? Only limited amount of air is supplied over here, whereas here there is sufficient supply of air. So these are the differences between what? Between slow combustion and rapid combustion. One more example is there. It consumes more time because it is burning slowly, so it will take more time, whereas rapid combustion will take less time. And that's the reason, children, in slow combustion there is incomplete burning of combustible material. That's why what happens? Due to the lack of oxygen, the fuel not reacts completely, and this in turn produces what? Carbon monoxide. It produces carbon monoxide and soot. That's the reason that incomplete combustion, or you can say slow combustion, is more harmful because of the release of this carbon monoxide. It is more harmful for us than that of carbon dioxide. Now come to the third topic, that is the spontaneous combustion. From the name only, children, it is clear. What do you mean by spontaneous combustion? Spontaneous combustion means a type of combustion which takes place on its own. Even at room temperature also it can take place without igniting the substance. Okay, it does not require any ignition point to start it, or it takes place automatically without supplying it heat or without supplying it light. Spontaneous combustion does not require heat or spark externally. It does not require heat or spark externally. It takes place without any external source. And what are the examples of spontaneous combustion? A piece of white phosphorus a piece of sodium. These are the examples of white phosphorus. Children, in previous class, I taught you that white phosphorus is a non-metal. Do you remember? I taught you that white phosphorus is a non-metal and it catches fire on its own without supplying any external heat to it. It catches fire, that's why it is placed in kerosene in order to protect it, or you can say in order to keep it safely, it has been placed in kerosene. Then the third one is explosive combustion. Explosive combustion, it is, as we take an example of explosive combustion, then what comes in our mind? Can you say anyone? It comes that the explosion of crackers. It is an example of explosive combustion. It is a very fast combustion reaction, and when a mixture of material and air burns here completely, it takes place in very short duration of time, and the combustion is almost uncontrolled. It releases very large amount of heat, light and sound also. So, example of explosive combustion is what? Bursting of crackers. Bursting of crackers is an example of explosive combustion. And when we do a comparative study between spontaneous combustion and explosive combustion, then we find that it takes place automatically, but it does not take place automatically. Then it releases heat and light, but this, along with the emission of heat and light, explosive combustion releases sound also. Now, there is a question in our mind that why there is release of sound in case of explosive combustion. A large amount of gases is also released quickly in this explosive combustion. So, what happens? The sound is produced, and this sound is due to the rapid expansion of these gases. The sound produced is due to the rapid expansion of these gases. Now children, you are able to understand now that what is slow combustion, what is rapid combustion, what is spontaneous combustion and what is explosive combustion. Now have a look on your today's assignment. Your today's assignment is number 1, describe the different types of combustion along with its example. Now, okay children, that's all.